So I am on the hunt again. I've actually, over the last few days, been using various apps to hunt for comic collections in my surrounding area. Specifically, OfferUp and Let Go are the two apps that I've been using. So about 3 days ago, I identified a small collection that a guy was offering up, including 25 high-grade Amazing Spider-Man comics. So I saw the ad, I reached out to the guy, had a conversation with him about, you know, what he was selling, why he was selling, et cetera, et cetera. And I basically learned that he was selling the collection, or at least this part of the collection, to afford a Hulk 181. So we had a really good conversation about that. I basically told him that I would reach back out to him if I indeed was interested in the collection. So a day goes by. I am searching on Craigslist. I basically see an ad that looks strangely like the one that I just saw on Let Go. And sure enough, the same guy basically had an ad on Craigslist advertising the same books for the exact same price. But what I noticed in the details was that this ad had gone up 10 days prior to and had been updated 3 days ago. So this gives me a clue that this guy has been out there trying to promote these books for a little over a week, probably with no takers, right? Because the books haven't sold. So they're still out there, still at the exact same price. And so I go back to Let Go and I start a communication with him again. And I basically offer him a price that is, I think, substantially lower than his original asking price. And I think he was asking for basically $35 a book. I offered him a price of $20 a book. He countered at $24 and I was like, done deal, right? So I'm basically going to pick up, hopefully today, 25 high-grade Amazing Spider-Man books at $24 each, which is not bad. Now, here's the thing. I actually have most of these comics already. There are six of the 25 that I don't have that I need for the collection, but I have a feeling that his 25 books are going to be higher grade than the books that I already have. So what I'll end up doing is keeping all 25 of his books, selling my under copies, and hopefully at least breaking even on the overall deal while basically upgrading 25 books that I essentially already have. So fingers crossed that this works out. I am actually driving to an area called Stockton, which is about an hour away from my house. I've never actually been to Stockton before, so this will be my first time there. Hopefully I can meet this guy, the transaction goes smoothly, and then I'm back in the car, headed back home for at least another hour. But again, at the end, if this all works out, this will be money and time well spent. So as you guys know, I'm definitely going to keep you updated on my progress over the course of like this transaction. I'll provide photos and all that kind of stuff as best I can. And if I walk away with these books, stay tuned until the end because I'll absolutely be showing you guys every one of the books that I picked up. So I am back in the comic book room and ready to show you guys the books that I picked up during the hunt in Stockton, California the other day. I've actually already sold one of the books, but thankfully there were two copies in the stack here, so I'll be able to represent it. And I've also already switched out a couple of the books for my personal copies because the books that I picked up are actually better in some cases than the ones that I already had in the personal collection. So I'll try to highlight those. And then there's also a couple that I'm probably going to hold on to because they're actually really high grade and actually are comparable to the one that I already have in the collection. So I'll probably submit both and then keep the one that has the highest grade and then find an owner a little bit later for the newly slabbed book. So the first book that I have up is Amazing Spider-Man 191. I actually already have a copy of this book. It's a really nice copy. My copy actually happens to be better, but this is a pretty nice solid copy of a sub 100 Amazing Spider-Man. Next up is Amazing Spider-Man number 103. I've already swapped this one out. I actually picked this book up not that long ago, but the one that I picked up in Stockton was actually in better shape, so I went ahead and swapped it out. And one thing that you can notice is that the wrap on this one isn't as perfect as it should be.
The version that I'm keeping actually has a better wrap. And the other big thing is that the whites on this one are not as white as the version that I'm holding. And it's really not noticeable until you put them side by side and then you realize how this one is a little yellow versus the one that I'm holding. So hopefully someone will appreciate this because it's still a really nice copy of Amazing Spider-Man 103. Next up, we have two copies of Amazing Spider-Man 123. This is actually the first appearance of Power Man, aka Luke Cage, in Amazing Spider-Man. I actually already have one copy of this, and I have a really nice copy that I will actually hold on to, but I was able to pick up two additional copies that I will hopefully be able to find a buyer for. Next up, Amazing Spider-Man 105. I actually already have this one as well. This copy is a really nice copy, as is my copy, which is why I put the little blue tape on it to remind me that I want to hold on to this one because this one could potentially receive a higher grade than the book that I already have. The one downside to this book is that the cover is white, so it's a little dingy, and then it also has some printer's ink here on this side. So I think that CGC would probably ignore that if I ever submit this one, but again, I'm going to hold on to this copy just in case. Next up, Amazing Spider-Man 109. This is another book that I picked up recently featuring Doctor Strange. My copy is actually better than this one. This one has a little stain down here in the corner, and the yellows aren't as vibrant as the version that I have, but still a really nice copy of 109. Next up, I have two copies of Amazing Spider-Man 118. Both of these books are really nice. My copy just happens to be a little bit better. This one, you can see that the wrap isn't as good, and it was cut across the top, so it was miscut here, but it's still a nice copy. Same thing with the second version. Both of these are really nice. My copies that I have just happen to be better. Next up is Amazing Spider-Man 129. This book, for whatever reason, is such a hard book to find in great shape. This guy gave it a 9.4 when he went through and graded it. I'm actually going to hold on to this book because I think it's actually in solid shape and may be comparable to the version that I already have. But he actually makes mention here that this is the first mention of Harry Osborn becoming the Green Goblin. So definitely a cool book to have. And again, for whatever reason, a hard book to find and decent shape. So here is Amazing Spider-Man 131. I already have a copy of this in my collection. It's in really nice shape. I sold a copy already of this that was in nice shape, and this is the under copy. This is the third best copy out of the three that I owned. And again, it is still a nice copy that will hopefully find a good owner. Next up, we have Mind Worm. This is Amazing Spider-Man 138. I think this is the first appearance of Mind Worm. This is actually a pretty cool issue that I read probably a month ago. It was different. It was a different kind of issue, but it was an enjoyable one. So this is a pretty cool book in decent shape. Nothing that jumps out at me as being truly defective. A couple of spine ticks, but par for the course, right? Next up, we have Amazing Spider-Man at number 140. This is a book that I already have, but I am actually going to keep it. This guy gave it a 9.2. It could actually be a 9.2. I mean, it has a miscut up here at the top, but the book is in solid shape. I'm definitely a fan of this particular cover. And so again, I'm going to hold on to this one and see which might have the better grade down the road. Same thing for Amazing Spider-Man 144. I think this is where like the clone of Gwen Stacy was spotted by Peter Parker, hence this cover right here. This is a really nice book. It is a black cover. This book is in pretty solid shape, as is the one that I already have in the collection. So I'm actually going to hold on to this one a little bit longer. Next up, we have Amazing Spider-Man 146. I'm not sure if there's anything significant about this book. I already have a copy. My copy is pretty solid, so we're going to move this one on. Same thing for the next one, Amazing Spider-Man 152. It was really close between my book and this copy. This one has a little bit of a dog ear corner up here. Mine doesn't have that, but both of them are in solid shape. Mine just edges out just a little bit on that dog ear, and if I remember correctly, the inside page color of mine is slightly better than this one. And again, these are minor details that you see when you put the book side by side and kind of examine them. You know, if you look at this book in isolation, it's a nice book. When you compare it to another copy, then you can see some of those minute differences between the two. Next up, Amazing Spider-Man 176. Really nice copy of this. I already have a copy of this one as well. And mine is a newsstand just like this one, but my copy was a little bit better on the inside and back cover than was this copy. Next up, Amazing Spider-Man 191. Again, I already have this book. Mine's in better shape, but again, this is a really nice book. Same thing for 192. Really cool book here. This is a really clean copy of this book. I don't think there's anything significant that happens here, but it's definitely a nice book to have in the collection. Next up, 193. Same thing here. I have a copy of this, but it's a nice book. Next, 198. I have one copy. My copy isn't in great shape. This copy isn't in great shape, but I am actually going to hold on to both of them until I find a much better copy versus the two that I have, and then I'll find a new home for these. So there you have it. That is essentially the haul of books that I picked up in Stockton, California. As I've mentioned, I've already sold one of these books. My hope is that I can find a home for some of the others and recoup some of the money that I actually spent to upgrade the books. At least fingers crossed, that is the hope. There's no guarantees with any of this stuff, but it's definitely fun to try some different approaches to collecting and upgrading comics. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. And as always, if you need me, feel free to reach out to me at ReggieCollects on Instagram and ReggieCollects@gmail.com. If you are not yet a subscriber of the channel, I definitely want to encourage you to hit that subscription button and also turn on notifications so that you can stay abreast of all the content that I release on a weekly basis. Take care.